think about doing a scale, like any scale, really major scale we're talking about here. So a couple of different ways, right? So I'm going to do, this is a G major scale. So it's the same as C, except it has a F sharp instead of an F for the 7. It has a F sharp because it's a half step down, right? So G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, and G. Two octaves, right? So I can think about it as the notes if I want to. G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, and G. But I can also think about it as degrees if I want to. So degrees are symbol, that's tonic, right, to the, and then steps, right? So tonic, whole step, half step, whole step, whole step, whole step, half step. And then tonic, whole step, half step, whole step, whole step, half step, whole step. So that's another way to look at it. We could also think about, so that's the notes and the intervals, right? We could also think about it as degrees, which is the number of the, I guess the scale number you might think about. So it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 1. And we could also think about it as like where your fingers are in the neck of the guitar. And that's how a lot of guitar players get started, especially with the like pentatonic shapes and that kind of thing. So in this case, it's in the first position, 3rd fret open, 2nd fret, 3rd fret open, 2nd fret, 4th fret open, and open, 2nd fret open, 1st fret, 3rd fret open, 2nd fret, 3rd fret. So four different ways of thinking of the same thing. And you can do that basically for every scale, every major scale. Now, why would you do that in the first place? Well, if you think about it only one way, like where you put your fingers, right? That's sort of limiting. But if you recognize that there's different ways to think about those guys, you can think about them all those ways or some of those ways or whatever works for you. Now, especially useful when you start thinking about, you know, your flat 3 and your flat 7. So flat 3 and flat 7 are, flat 3, for instance, for the G would be between the 2 and the 3. So here's your G. There's 1. There's a G right there. Now, 2 for the major scale would be here, a whole step up. And then 3 is another whole step up. But a flat 3 has to be between the 2 and the 3. So that's going to be here someplace, right? It's also, if you think about it, the first degree here, and then the flat 3 is here. Now, if I think about this as simply degrees, right? My flat 3 is right on top of the flat 7, and my 1 is right on top of the 5. So I've got bum, 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 bum. One way to think about it, right? If you can think about the notes, if that works for you. Think about the degrees, if that works for you. Think about the intervals, if that works for you. So from the 1, right, the next interval the next interval is a whole interval and a half interval, which is right here in the flat 3. And then a flat 7, of course, is a whole step down below the 1, except not a half step, because that's where your 7th is for a major scale, right? Your major 7th, this is your dominant 7. And then your 5 is a step and a half below the flat 7. So useful to think about these guys all different ways. It also helps us when we, like, consider this, right? So you talk about your G scale, first degree, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But you could also play that same notes. Check it out. And another one of the beautiful things about a guitar, it's exactly the same notes, and here are exactly the same notes. Those were all the same notes, all played in a different way, a different position on the neck of the guitar. They all have the same relationship. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 1, or, you know, tonic, whole step, half step, whole step, whole step, whole step, half step, or whatever the notes are, you know, G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, and G, or 3rd fret. Now this is where it's different, because although it's all the same, now we're in a different position, so that might go 3rd fret, 5th fret, 7th fret, 3rd fret, 5th fret, 7th fret, 4th fret, 5th fret, right? Bum, 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 bum. Same notes as here. 3rd fret open, 2nd fret, 3rd fret open, 2nd fret, 4th fret open, right? And the same notes as here. 3rd fret, 5th fret, 2nd fret, 3rd fret, fifth fret, second fret, fourth fret, fifth fret. So be open to thinking about stuff that in a different way, and it will certainly, oh my God, it'll be so much easier to consider stuff like you want to play like blues scales. Now that's just, I was just showing off here, but that, I mean, it's the same idea, right? Same, once you understand the patterns and being able to understand them in different ways, right? You can look at those patterns and gain some mastery over what you're doing. You don't just got to put your fingers where you think you're supposed to.